Hello and welcome to We the People. I'm Gargi Rawat. Now, over this last month, unless you've been living under a rock or been completely cut off from the outside world, you couldn't have escaped the images from the two big celebrity weddings. That's Deepika and Ranveer's and Priyanka Chopra and Nick Jonas' wedding. And now to cap it off, this whole entire year of big weddings and this season of big weddings, we have the biggest of them all, which is Mukesh Ambani's daughter Isha Ambani's wedding to Anand Piramal, where you have one of the world's biggest pop stars, Beyonce, performing. So today on We the People, we're discussing the phenomena of the big fat Indian wedding, how they're getting bigger and fatter, and what do they mean for us as a society? Because let's face it, we're also a country where dowry deaths and female feticide is a reality. So do these massive weddings and the hype and hoopla around them continue to maintain this pressure on society regarding weddings and the pomp and show that must accompany them? Or is this just another very many of India's paradoxes that we have? We have so many in our country. Well, to talk more about this today on the show, we have Dilip Cherian, CEO Perfect Relations, Leher Kala, columnist and someone who runs a film company that actually makes wedding films, Archana Dalmia, social activist, Chetan Bora, wedding planner, wedding line, and he just did Priyanka Chopra's reception in Delhi. Reena Dhaka, fashion designer, someone who has actually seen this evolution of the wedding fashion. And Vishesh Ravi, MLA from Aam Aadmi Party, and someone who had a very, very simple community wedding. So we're going to talk to him about that. But before that, Dilip Cherian, to you, what do you think about this whole hoopla that we've seen around these celebrity weddings? And do you feel this creates a pressure on society, or is it just a sign of the times we live in?
I think that one needs to look at it in a historic sense also, to just get perspective on what we're looking at. The big fat Indian wedding has been something that the big people of the country have always wanted. And, you know, from the Rajas and the Maharajas, it then cascaded down to those who considered themselves noble sort of successors to that kind of pomp and glory. But the real question is, what's changed since the 1991 when the liberalization took place and we created this huge new middle class which aspired to spend and show? Spending was good, profit was great, and showing was okay. Then we've got into a phase now where, like most successful Indian businessmen looking for a second passport, a lot of the big players in the wedding business are now looking to do their weddings overseas for making sure that it is covered just the way they want it covered. So we've seen the entire transition. In fact, the fact is that even the biggest of the weddings that you're talking about, a lot of them, the main action is going to happen overseas. So is this a good thing? I'm not so sure. In fact, if we have the
about
wedding,
the business going overseas?
The business going overseas. I'm talking about the business going overseas. But in terms of the message it gives, it clearly shows that India has a bunch of people who have both the surplus cash as well as the willingness to display it. And what better sign or a point of time to display
it? So we've moved a long way from the time of our Gandhian values, and now it's no longer less is more, it's more is more. You think, but you know, do you think the messaging
will, to my mind, the change will come because millennials are now opting for simpler weddings. Many millennials, and I'm not...
Well, I've seen articles about that, but I'm not sure. Do you think that that's something we're seeing?
There's no doubt that that's happening. Wedding planners may not say it and show it, but they're all nervous about it because today's kids are increasingly looking at doing things their way. It may sometimes, you know, involve shooting underwater in the Arctic or something, but, you know, they may spend huge amounts of money, but it's not the same pomp, scale and show which
I was also going to talk about social media. That's become a big part of this whole wedding industry and what we've seen in these celebrity weddings, and millennials are very much a part of that social media world.
They watch it. I'm not sure how they react to it. So I think that they are very much part of the social media world, but I think that they see this hype and many of them are turning away from that, and that's a good sign. That's my sense from talking to kids, though of course I must confess that I have also talked to kids, including grandkids, who say, no, they want the big fat wedding.
Okay, well, it was interesting that you spoke of 1991, because I was going to talk about that this whole angst over this consumerist society that we're becoming, is it something that people who come from that pre-liberalization era, that we think about it more and the millennials don't really think about it that
in
much?
In economic terms, profit is good equals that you can show your profit. So if you want to have an economy which is growing and bustling and people are wanting to be entrepreneurs, then you've got to sit down and swallow the fact that some of them will make huge profits, have disproportionate assets, not illegally, I hope, and will show exactly what they want at the time they want.
All right, Archana Dalmia, what is your opinion of this? I know that you feel very strongly that it just gets all too much.
I just feel appalled at the way people are spending at weddings. You know, I feel the big fat Indian wedding needs to go on a diet. They're spending so much, and it percolates down to the middle class, to the poor. You know, whenever you talk about these weddings, there's a scene which comes to my mind that there was this wedding of somebody in Hyderabad, Janardhan Reddy.
Yes.
Who
and that was during demonetization.
During the demonetization time. And he was spending over 500 crores on his daughter's wedding, with the sari being about 17 crores. I mean, these are figures which I got from social media. And he had this huge temple
thing.
There was
the invitation card with an iPad.
And there were months of preparation. And in contrast, you had this poor farmer who was standing in line with all his life savings to go. It was demonetization. So he was getting his money changed. And he had saved about maybe 50,000 rupees. So the contrast and the disparity between this is so much that it appalls me at the wastage that's happening. And it's appalling.
But don't you feel, I mean, that, as I said in the introduction, that these are the paradoxes we all live through in
well,
India.
There's a
you know,
shift
this,
in
we
generation.
Have poverty, we have, yeah, you know,
but
this ostentation.
This is, there is a shift in generation. And the new generation probably likes this. But my generation, I feel very strongly about this, that, you know, there's so much wastage. I think there's so much wastage, whether it be clothes. Well, in the recent
right,
wedding,
in fact, this weekend,
we have two designers sitting with us. In the recent wedding, I mean, they're changing. The only people who must be smiling are the designers.
Well, Sabyasachi for sure, because
yeah,
I think
sure.
his designs are something
bride,
everyone aspires to.
I think maybe even if she wanted to, she must be, you know, those heavy lehengas that they wear, which maybe as heavy as 20 kilos?
Not really, but about.
But again, it comes down to choices,
hurting.
And it's their choice. Maybe they
yeah,
they want,
sure,
you know, because
this,
the wedding, the way it is in our Indian culture,
but
and across the world, it's considered
I also think
big
it's
deal,
a lot
and
of
we all
pressure.
Aspire to a
it's
you
a
know perfect
of,
wedding.
No, but I think it's a lot of pressure. Also, you want to do better and better. And I think media is also a lot responsible for this.
Right. I think I agree with you there, because we've seen a lot of media coverage, very breathless coverage of various details, Priyanka Chopra's veil to invitation cards,
I mean,
to what went on at the various receptions that Deepika and Ranveer had. But Reena Dhak, as someone who's watched the evolution of this entire wedding industry and the designer industry around these weddings, what is your opinion of the big fat Indian wedding?
My opinion is that it's each to his own, but there is the evolution. What you're talking about is that this is a parallel industry today. When I came into the scene a few, like almost two and a half decades ago, we didn't have an industry wherein our set designer today may be the biggest wedding event planner. The people who have worked in our fashion industry are some of the guys behind those opulent set designs which you see. And there is now a system in place. There are many categories of vendors. You have the set designer, you will have the card industry designer, you will have the makeup crew. We didn't have all that when you're saying evolution. You have makeup for your guest crew, so there's a different team for them. Hair and makeup always given at the, if you're a guest at, then there's a gifting crew who will create those special gifts for you. There are these like Whizcraft level of companies which only, you know, coordinate the guest movement, your reception, taking care
but
of
are we
them.
Just talking about a small percentage of society?
I mean, of course, this can't be more than 2% who can afford such a category. But these systems, there's a whole huge army of people sustaining that crew or the wedding of those two guys. It's now a in an industry of a remarkable size.
So all right, well, Chetan, as the wedding planner here.
So, you know, there are over 10 million.
I believe it's an industry that's growing by 20%.
Oh, my God, the profit margins are
40. The wedding industry is a recession-proof industry. It doesn't matter, come demonetization or whatnot.
Well,
Indians will spend big on their weddings.
Well, if you ask some of us, we'll say that's a myth. It is not, it's not that it's not recession-free. But see, there are about 10 million weddings that happen, Indian weddings that happen every year. It's a $40 to $50 billion industry that has spun off in the last 10 odd years. Today you've got conclaves, you've got kids who are out of college who are aspiring and coming back to companies to want to train with us, to want to become event planners and wanting to become wedding planners. What Dilip said earlier about the millennials wanting to shift it, I think there's a definite change where people actually observe what somebody is doing and then come back and say, okay, this has been done, I want something different. So there were people who'd come back and say, till the Rajasthans and the Keralas happened, it was the big thing in India. Then somebody woke up to a Thailand, and somebody's woken up to Europe, and someone's woken up to Lake Como. That's become the flavor of the season. So it all depends on where the flavor is, who's actually looking at, and there will be a buyer. There will be a buyer for every product that you really have. I think it's a little unfair to generalize all the clients who have weddings to get up and say that it's a big fat Indian wedding. We look at it from an economic perspective. Like Reena very rightfully said, it is a huge industry that's spun off. The kind of employment that we do, there's some of us from associations that are talking to governments and telling them about the facts and figures of employment numbers, of the taxes that we generate for the government, for the foreign exchange that we generate for the government. So these are all aspects that very conveniently sometimes do get forgotten or are shadowed under the pretext of what social media is doing. Exactly.
And wasteful expenditure.
I think a wedding is far bigger on social media than it is on ground. And because the gates are shut and people can't come inside that palace or can't come inside, there are a lot of stories that come on. So maybe the veil wasn't as big as it was. Maybe the cake wasn't as high as it was. But what you've seen and what the make-believe world of social media is what the rest of the general public believes, and that's exactly what's happening.
All right, well, earlier we spoke to comedian and actor Veer Das about the big fat Indian wedding, so let's just take a look at that. Veer, now you've been following social media recently, and the great Indian wedding is all that's being talked about over the last month. Have you seen it, and what's your reaction to it?
I've seen the great Indian weddings, the two big great Indian weddings, and congratulations to both couples. So yeah, I have seen them. My reaction to them is that, well, I got married with no cell phones allowed at my wedding, on a beach with 70 people, and we took away their cell phones. And I was kind of not sure about that decision when that happened, and I now feel more sure about that decision than I ever have. So yeah.
All right, so you took away the cell phones because you didn't want anyone releasing any pictures. You didn't want your pictures to come out.
So that no pictures out. Also, I didn't give any money for pictures. It's not like I had any exclusive, you know, Vanity Fair pictures. I don't know. There's very good paneer at my wedding. So if Vanity Fair is interested in pictures of beautiful paneer, please contact me.
All right, well, there's been a lot of angst over it, you know, about the big fat wedding. Social media people are saying that it's also a big waste of money. So what do you feel about that?
If you think it is a big waste of money, you should be realizing the fact that it is a big waste of somebody else's money that you do not have. So maybe when you go and star in the biggest historical fiction movie in Bollywood, or an ABC series surrounding you, or when you and your equally chocolatey looking brothers release many, many music albums, you can spend your money on whatever the hell you like. But if you see somebody spending their hard-earned money, maybe shut up. Let him enjoy it.
All right. Well, okay, Veer, thanks for that. So, Lair, what do you feel about what Veer had to say? It's people spending their own money any which way that
they want. I'm a direct beneficiary of the wedding industry because 8-9 years ago, I started a film company. And we make cool wedding movies. And what I can say is that people of all walks of life in India are very passionate about weddings in their families. It's not just the rich, it's not just the poor. It's an occasion for family members to get together and hang around. And to add to what Dilip said about millennials not wanting to have big weddings, the families I see when film, and I see them at close quarters, the people getting married have no say. It's the parents who are deciding. You know, it's the wedding is for the older generation. It's not for the 25-year-olds getting married. And to add to that about the ostentation, you know, there's a terrible dichotomy in extreme wealth. Because if you look at Mr. Ambani, you know, you've got the yachts, you've got the private jets, you've got everything, the holiday homes. What do you do with it? You can't hoard anymore. You know, you've left enough for your future generations. And I think, you know, the so fact that he's an A-lister.
Your daughter's getting married. Then
the deal of being an A-lister is that you have to put on a show for the rest of the world. If Mukesh Ambani starts living like the rest of us, life would be very boring, don't you think?
there's a popular saying that we say, Leher, which says that if the rich don't spend, the poor won't earn.
Yeah.
So that's very
cool. Well,
that's very interesting. But I'd like to go to Vishesh Ravi next. And aap Aam Aadmi Party ke MLA. Aur aapne apni shaadi jab 2 saal pehle hui thi, bahut simply karai thi, community wedding karai thi, apne saath aur bhi logo ki shaadiyan karai thi. Uske baare mein aap zara bataye, aapne kyun aise kiya?
फैमिली में डिसाइड हुआ, डिस्कस हुआ और ये लगा कि क्योंकि एमएलए हैं और एक अच्छी शादी करना बहुत आसान है और लोग आएंगे और एंजॉय करके जाएंगे, लेकिन अगर इस तरह से शादी करते हैं तो शायद एक मैसेज जाएगा। जो लोग कर्जा करते हैं, गहने बेचते हैं, अपनी ज़मीन गिरवी रखते हैं अपने बच्चों की शादी करने के लिए और उसके बाद फिर 20 साल पीछे चले जाते हैं, यानी एक शादी करने के लिए एक परिवार को जितना खर्चा करता है वो 20 साल पीछे चले जाता है और फिर से 20 साल वो सेविंग करता है एक और शादी करने के लिए। तो उस सबको देखते हुए ऐसा लगा कि शायद हमारे ऐसा करने से शायद सोसाइटी में कुछ चेंज आएगा, या जो लोग हिचकते हैं कम्युनिटी वेडिंग करने में,
थोड़ा शर्म आती लोगों की, छोटी शादी करेंगे जी, लोग क्या बोलेंगे?
जी, जी जी, तो यही था कि विधायक का अगर शादी करेगा ऐसा से तो शायद लोग कुछ सोच में बदलाव आएगा, और ऐसा हुआ भी। मुझे खुशी है कि बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं लेकिन हमारे ही 5-6 वॉलंटियर्स हैं जिन्होंने मेरी शादी के बाद, उनकी 2 साल में शादी हुई है, बहुत ही सिंपल उन्होंने शादियाँ की और सब लोग खुश हैं होपफुली।
और आपकी वाइफ ने इजीली मान लिया ये कि मतलब सिंपल शादी, क्योंकि लेडीज में रहता है कि एवरीवन वांट्स टू हैव अ बिग फैट वेडिंग, वो मान गई कि सिंपल शादी,
वो मान गई। उनको हम थैंक्स अभी तक करते हैं, धन्यवाद करते हैं पूरी फैमिली का, क्योंकि हम पॉलिटिकल फिगर है, बैकग्राउंड से है, तो हमारे लिए फिर एक लोग कह सकते हैं कि इससे माइलेज मिलेगा, इससे अच्छा लगेगा लोगों को, लेकिन वो फैमिली और स्पेशली जिसकी शादी है लड़की की, उनके लिए मुश्किल था क्योंकि हर लड़की का सपना होता है शादी के दिन एकदम बढ़िया से अच्छी शादी हो। लेकिन अभी जो मैं सुन रहा था या हम अभी देख रहे हैं, उसको देख के ऐसा लगता है कि शादी जो है वो जीवन का अंत है। जिस तरह से शादी की जा रही है, ये जिन बड़ी शादियों को हम कर रहे हैं, देख रहे हैं, ऐसा लगता है कि इसके बाद कुछ नहीं है। लेकिन अगर हम देखें सच में तो शादी के बाद तो असली जीवन का संघर्ष शुरू होता है। मतलब अगर देसी भाषा में कहें तो आटे दाल का भाव जो है वो शादी के बाद समझ में आता है। लेकिन ये शादियां हो रही हैं, ऐसा लगता है कि बस इसके बाद कुछ नहीं है, जितना कर दिया और करना है इसी में करना है, उसके बाद कुछ नहीं है। लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है।
और आपने अपने साथ कितनी शादियां कराई थी?
हमारे जब शादी हुई 10 शादी थी, उसमें एक कुक थे, एक टेलर थे और कुछ लोग थे। तो मुझे लगता है कि जब कोई भी पब्लिक फिगर है, जितने भी लोगों ने जिनकी हमने बात की भी, 3 लोगों की, 3 कपल्स की, ये तीनों पब्लिक फिगर है, और जब ऐसे पब्लिक फिगर कुछ करते हैं तो सोसाइटी मैसेज जाता है, और अगर हम अच्छा करते हैं तो उसका अच्छा मैसेज जाता है, और अगर हम कुछ भी ऐसा करते हैं तो उसका मैसेज अच्छा नहीं जाता। शादी बड़ा ही पवित्र एक बंधन है, और उसको जितना हम अच्छा से करते हैं, डिसेंट से करते हैं, मुझे लगता है कि जो जो इफेक्शन है वो जो है और अच्छा होता है।
ऑलराइट, वेल अर्चना,
दैट्स अ गुड पॉइंट, बिकॉज़ यू नो इफ फॉर एग्जांपल सोशल मीडिया कैन हाइप अप द ऑस्टेंटेशियसनेस ऑफ अ वेडिंग, एंड आई एग्री दैट यू नो the size of the cake or the length of the veil could be the subject of lots of gossip and lots of speculation. But I think that perhaps social media is missing out on the simplicity of this and not focusing on it. But I think there are a bunch of people who are listening to other voices. And I think that when you hear the sounds of new drums, like an MLA marrying like this, I think there will be a new kind of message
rather
goes
than
out.
The ready wedding
that
took
right.
place in Bangalore, no, where
the big weddings are. But also, don't forget that the number
and
of
maybe
big weddings,
the media also need to emphasize weddings like
and
that
cover them.
People who are
and
choosing,
perhaps
yes.
cover them. Okay, but I think that the numbers in proportion, I would say, meaning I know that people in the business are here and they'd be able to give you figures, but the numbers of people who are willing to go out and show that are now not as high as they used to be just 5 years ago. आई थिंक देयर हैज बीन अ चेंज वेदर इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ टैक्सेशन एंड एंग्जाइटी ऑन दैट अकाउंट बट वेन यू हैव द केस ऑफ समबडी पोस्ट डिमोनेटाइजेशन हैविंग ऑलरेडी स्पेंट लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ द कैश बिफोर बींग विलिंग टू डू दैट आई डोंट नो बट आई थिंक दैट देयर विल बी अ चेंज एंड आई कैन स्निफ दैट चेंज कमिंग Even though parents may still want
to. I know what Raviji was saying about the fact that people get set back years. They borrow, they go into debt, and then they
afford wedding. I don't see this going back. I see it moving more and more forward. I see people spending more and more money. And I see the disparity becoming wider and wider. You know, my maid, she came to me and she said, Didi, humko 1 lakh rupiah chahiye. I said, why? So she said, मेरी बहन की शादी है सो आई सेड तू 1 लाख रुपया लेके क्या करेगी शादी में हमको सारे गांव को खिलाना पड़ता है आई सेड खिलाना क्यों पड़ता है सो शी सेड नहीं तो फिर गांव में हमारी कोई इज्जत नहीं करेगा यू नो दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ मैसेज दैट इज गोइंग ऑन वी हैव टू स्टॉप समवेयर दिस इज अ बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन टू पीपल आर गेटिंग मैरिड
राइट
And you know, and they've made it so impersonal with thousands of people attending your wedding. Where not if we both are at a wedding, we might not see each other because there's so many people.
But again, it comes down to choice. But I found very interesting what Ravi said about you know, this is not the end all. It's
the beginning.
The marriage is there going forward. In fact, for this show today, I'd wanted to get this couple we'd featured. They'd done a green wedding a few years ago, and it was a very low carbon footprint wedding. Except that they were divorced now, so it was so again there like coming back that you know it's not so much the wedding, it's the marriage we need to talk about also a lot.
But I must tell you, how much you spend or don't spend is no indication of how your married life will turn out. So whether you spend 5 crores or 10 rupees doesn't mean the guy who's spending 10 rupees is going to be happier, you know, or vice versa.
It's pressure, you know. I just want to tell you about this. I know about this young couple. The boy went and proposed to a girl. He chartered a flight and proposed to her in, you know, while they were flying. And they were divorced 3 months after they were wedded. So, you know, the kind of examples that are coming to you of the kind of money that is being spent is unimaginable.
But those examples won't be there amongst people who haven't spent.
Yeah, but I just feel that the social pressure of this on the people who can't afford it becomes so much. Also,
okay,
you
so
see
let me pose that to the audience here. How many of you feel that these big weddings create too much social pressure on common folk? It goes down in society. Okay. So, Haji ji, aap dekh bataiye. So, very few people think it creates social pressure. And how many of you think it's okay? It's not no big deal that you have these big fat weddings. Okay, nobody wants to be seen, but yes, let me get your voice in here. Tell me what you think.
Hello, I think it creates a lot of pressure because everyone wants a big fat wedding in India. It's a lot of pressure, and these big public figures can set an example by giving a small budget and donating to others. Though that money can be used in very various charities also, but they spent so much of money.
So having said that, the Bani wedding, I believe that they're feeding many people as well. Every day they're feeding people, so. Yeah.
But no, still,
they have the money. So, do you feel it's all right? I mean, Mukesh Ambani, his daughter's getting married. He's feeding 5,000 people every day. So,
लेकिन आप शादी कैसे कर रहे हैं उससे आप संदेश क्या दे रहे हैं मैसेज क्या दे रहे हैं
इम्प्रेशन ऑन अस लाइक फॉर मी इफ आई एम गेटिंग मैरिड आई विल बी लुकिंग टू दीपिका'स फोटोज एंड आई विल बी लाइक आई वांट टू ड्रेस अप लाइक हर एंड आई डोंट वांट टू डू लाइक दिस बट दिस विल क्रिएट अ प्रेशर ऑन मी एंड माय पेरेंट्स आल्सो सो आई थिंक अ लिटिल बजट शुड बी अ लिटिल लेस सो दैट वी कैन हैव अ बेटर
जब तक ये अपने लिए सोच रहे हैं कि मैं दीपिका की तरह ड्रेसअप हूँ तब तक तो फिर ठीक है लेकिन ये जब ये सोचना आ जाएगा कि इनका हस्बैंड रणवीर की तरह डसअप होके आए वो वैसे ही जो है गेटअप में आए उतनी महंगी शेरवानी में आए वो ही अरेंजमेंट में आए तो मुश्किल और बढ़
जाएगी एक और मेरा एक सजेशन है सॉरी कि बहुत सारी अब वेडिंग्स तो अब हर एक का पर्सनल इशू है उसमें हुआ वी टू सजेस्ट बट एक चीज हो सकती है कि यू नो केटरिंग बहुत ज्यादा फूड वेस्टेज होती है हर वेडिंग में. आई रियली विश के कोई तरीका हो, आप लोग गवर्नमेंट में हैं, आप लोग हेल्प कर सकते हैं, वेयर इन एक कोई सिस्टम फॉर्म हो जाए. जैसे हम सब इवेंट, वी हैव प्लान्स फॉर एवरीथिंग इन प्लेस, फ्रॉम द पुटिंग ऑफ द टेंट्स टू द रिमूवल टू द डिजाइन टू द पंडित टू द कलीरास, एवरी कैटेगरी इज देयर.
वी बीन थ्रू अ फेज ड्यूरिंग इंदिरा गांधी टाइम व्हेन देयर वाज अ वेडिंग कंट्रोल एक्ट ऑर्डर एंड यू कुड ओनली सर्व अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ 50 गेस्ट. And that also was decided what you could serve them. No more than 3 items. So we've been through that. So in a sense, the new India has come through that. And perhaps one generation has reacted against it.
In fact, interesting you should talk about that. Because I want to come to the point of how in 2016, there was an MP.
Ranjita Ranjan
who brought in this private members bill about just that. And that wasn't the only one. Yeah. Before that, there have been 6 bills over the last 20 years.
I think the food.
In 1996, you had the prohibition of lavish and extravagant expenditure on marriage and birthday. Celebration bill, birthdays was also there. 2005, another prohibition of extravagant expenditure bill. This was brought in the Lok Sabha. 2005 again. Then 2011, you had a prevention of extravagance, unlimited expenditure on marriage bill. And in 2011 again, you had the marriages simple solemnization, compulsory registration, and prevention of wastage of food items bills. All these bills. So there's obviously a lot of angst that we all feel about the wastage.
Private members' bills never become law.
Exactly. That is the other point. Yes.
Unless the government.
Political moves of
unless somebody on the top has the will and the demonstrative capability to do it.
Yeah.
But do you think it's something that should be done? Do we need the government to nanny us about how much we're spending?
There are some things on which I think I generally object to a nanny state. I don't think the state has the right to intervene. But I think the state has various other instruments by which it can achieve the same objective. And that is what it should exercise.
Like
for
what?
Example, I think that it's almost certain that many of these expenditures you can put a ceiling on without actually contravening any right to expenditure. You know, you can actually say that you can't have more than say 50,000 people or 5,000 people assembling for a thing like
this. All right, but Chetan, what would you think about something
like that? I'll give you a perspective on when we say wastage. You know, when you're looking at 400 people on the outside of a wedding, understand there are about double the number or maybe triple the number who are back-end suppliers, waiters or technicians or event crew or various other people who are coming together to do that. So when you do say that, yes, there is wastage, that's wastage on the front of it, what a guest sees. And I would agree that most of you are guests on weddings and you see
Rina
that.
And what Rina was saying, that we need a solution from to this food wastage.
From a perspective, in fact, there's all that food does, and we've done n number of events with leading hotels and leading caterers across, where after the wedding finishes and the guests like yourselves leave the venue, it is opened up for crew and waiters and various other people who come across an entire range of democratic thing. Everybody is there. So I would be eating with maybe a laborer who's actually put up flowers for me. I would be picking up my plate at the same time he's picking up the plate. So the food does not get waste. We did try this a few years ago of talking to a whole lot of people and having a discussion about wanting to go and make food packets and send them in refrigerated vans to under flyovers in various places. The agencies that we spoke to and with the government that we spoke to came back and told us that there are health safety, there's food safety, there are a whole lot of things. Tomorrow,
Raviji, aap shayad iske bare mein kuch kar sakte hain.
If a Mr. Ambani tonight decides to say there is huge thing, why don't you go out all over Udaipur and distribute this food to other people? One person decides to fall sick, and it doesn't have to be a prawn, it can be a bhindi as well, right? Okay. So at the end of the day, if that does happen, he will be on the media tomorrow morning on the front page of every newspaper to say that how he has gone ahead. And
okay, so these are some of the complications about that. Let me get in more questions here. Sad.
नमस्कार, मेरा नाम केएन छाबड़ा है. मैं 10 सीनियर सीजन्स दिलशाद गार्डन से आया हूँ. एनडीटीवी का बहुत धन्यवाद है. ये जो आज की डिस्कशन है इसके बारे में मैरिज सेलिब्रेशन वगैरह, ये बहुत ही कॉस्टली हो रही हैं. और आज के ज़माने में जो सिंपल जो हमारे MLA साहब ने कहा, मैं इसको अप्रिशिएट करता हूँ और इसको बहुत लाइक करता हूँ. क्योंकि जितना वेस्टेज होता है मटेरियल, फूड मटेरियल, ये अननेसेसरी वेस्टेज ऑफ मनी. और जो VIPs हैं जो शादियाँ करते हैं, ये भी बहुत एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी मतलब एक्सपेंडिचर होता है. इस पर कंट्रोल होना चाहिए.
आपको लगता है सोसाइटी पे प्रेशर बढ़ता है?
हाँ,
ऐसे और
जो लो क्लास है उनके लिए मुश्किल
की तरह ड्रेस होना चाहूँगी, अपने पेरेंट्स से मांगेंगी.
बिल्कुल, हमने हमारी फैमिली में भी 2 मैरिज हुई हैं, लेकिन हमारे सन इन लॉ बेटियाँ बहुत ठीक थे. हमारे विद इन मतलब लिमिट हमने काम किया है. तो ऐसे ही मैं औरों को भी यही प्रयास करूँगा कि मतलब काम करो, लिमिट में करो, इतना वेस्टेज नहीं होना चाहिए. थैंक यू.
ऑलराइट, थैंक यू फॉर दैट. लेट्स गेट सम यंगर पीपल इन.
हेलो मैडम, हेलो मैडम्स एंड सर्स.
यस गो अहेड.
ओके, आई एम प्रतीक पांड्या, स्टूडेंट ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली. आई हैव अ क्वेश्चंस दैट हाउ कैन दिस मैरिज, दिस लेवियस मैरिज एक्ट एज अ, आई थिंक जस्ट दिस कैन बी लिंक, दिस लेवियस मैरिज कैन लिंक विद द वेलफेयर ऑफ पुअर सेक्शन. जो आजकल के जो लेवियस मैरिजेज हो रहे हैं जो उनके, तो इनको हम कैसे लिंक कर सकते हैं, इसको एक मीडियम बना सकते हैं, एक माध्यम बना सकते हैं कि जो पुअर सेक्शंस हैं वो मतलब कि इससे जो है लाभान्वित हो जाएं. इस वजह से
जी, आई थिंक वी स्पोकन अ बिट अबाउट दैट. लेट्स आल्सो गेट सम मोर क्वेश्चंस.
हेलो, आई एम रवि गुप्ता एंड आई एम फ्रॉम AAFT. एंड मेरा क्वेश्चन जो है रवि सर से, अभी सर आपने बोला कि आपने अपने जो अपना जो शादी है वो बहुत कम बजट में किया, लेकिन छोटे छोटे गांव में ऐसे होते हैं कि वो कहते हैं कि ये कम लोगों को बुला के, कम लोगों को खाना खिला के बहुत कम खर्चा किया. तो आपने जो है कि सोसाइटी को एक मैसेज दिया, लेकिन उन लोगों की मानसिकता के लिए आपने क्या किया कि जो लोग कहते हैं,
तो आपको लगता है इनको और इसको बढ़ावा देना चाहिए, इसका पब्लिसिटी और जाके बात करनी चाहिए गांव में?
हाँ, नहीं वो मेंटालिटी वो जो है ना, हाउ टू
चेंज दिस मेंटालिटी. जैसे आप कह रहे हैं कि लोग डेट में चले जाते हैं, 20 साल पीछे इकोनॉमिकली चले जाते हैं, हम कैसे इसको इस मेंटालिटी को चेंज कर सकते हैं?
ज्यादा से ज्यादा मतलब जो लोग, जैसे हमने कहा कि पब्लिक फिगर है, जिनके कुछ भी करने से लोग फर्क पड़ता है लोगों को, उन लोगों को इसमें आगे आना पड़ेगा. और एक पॉइंट इसमें ऐड मैं करना चाहूँगा कि जिन दहेज उत्पीड़न या झूठे दहेज उत्पीड़न के जो केस हम देखते हैं, इससे भी वो जुड़े हुए हैं. आप देखिए, जब शादी होती है, महंगा हम इंतजाम करते हैं और बहुत सारे गिफ्ट देते हैं जो दहेज के नाम पर जाते हैं, उससे भी फैमिलीज के बीच में प्रॉब्लम हो जाती है. शादी जब थोड़ा कपल के प्रॉब्लम होती है तो सबसे पहले दहेज की बात आनी शुरू होती है कि मैंने दहेज इतना दिया, तुमने दहेज इतना मांगा, या किसी ने डिमांड की है, किसी डिमांड
की. आपको लगता है ये जुड़ा हुआ है, जो एक्सपेंडिचर जो शादियों में हो रहा है वो दहेज?
हमने शादी की थी तो उसमें हमने कोई चीज जो है नहीं ली थी, जस्ट सिर्फ शादी करने के बाद. और मतलब कोई चीज ना उससे प्रेशर. मुझे लगता है कि ना सिर्फ जो लड़की का परिवार है, लड़के के परिवार पर भी कोई प्रेशर नहीं है. आज मुझे अगर जो है कोई इस बात के लिए धमकाने की कोशिश करे कि मैंने डॉरी ली है या मेरी फैमिली को तंग करने की कोशिश करे, तो वो संभव नहीं है, क्योंकि ऐसा हुआ ही नहीं है. तो
मुझे
बिग वेडिंग्स दे राइट दैट दे गिव अ डिस्क्लेमर टू नॉट गिव अस गिफ्ट्स or give it to certain charities
like that. Yes, I'm saying pressure.
I just still feel the pressure is always on the woman or the girl. The families are pressurized that the girl, the dowry system has been removed. But in spite of that, the pressure is that the girl's family spends. You know, they have to have the pomp and the show, the barat will come and they have to do all this. That's also social pressure.
Because, of having a big wedding. Another point I wanted to bring up.
I also want to say that earlier on, Jaya Bhadri got married to an Amitabh Bachchan. It was a simple wedding. That was actually a wedding. Or when the wedding lehengas were heirlooms which were transferred from the mother to her daughter or to her daughter-in-law. Now these girls wear their lehengas maybe once, it'll never be worn again. You know, the kind of lehengas that it'll probably be out of style, and nobody'll wear it again.
So again, we come back to the wasted.
What I wanted to say is when Indira Gandhi got Rajiv married, I think Sonia and Priyanka wore the sari which was woven by Jawaharlal Nehru when he was in jail.
Yes, yes.
And it was a simple affair, yet it had, everybody was interested in knowing about it.
Do you think our netas should do more of that sort of messaging? It's a message
which they send, that a simple wedding will have as much meaning as this pomp and show, which becomes so impersonal.
Is there also a north-south divide when we talk about this big expenditure, or north versus the rest of India divide?
I think the north and south are competing with each other.
Yeah, south. Sad.
I think the south is. I think the south is bigger.
Yeah. Except that in the south, spends like mad.
South is bigger.
A couple of states are stand out as bigger examples of pomp and show. But I think that in general, what you're saying is a fairly north-south even thing. Maybe the parts of the east are left out simply because they don't have that kind of money at the moment.
Okay. So do you think that divide, Leher, you're telling us that there's no such divide?
You know, it's not really a valid point like that, but I just like to say that a lot of Indians don't have any joy in their lives, you know. Their lives are constant drudgery. So you have to look at a wedding from the point of view of the fact that it's a joyful occasion for the entire family. So while of course it's obviously people should not be selling their land and going backwards, but everyone needs occasions in which the days are different from an ordinary day, right? So if you start treating Diwali and a wedding as just like a regular day, you know, it just takes away those moments that make living so special. So I think for a lot of Indians, these weddings turn out to be a very, very unique and special thing.
And the whole
thing.
Family can get dressed up these days, of course.
Exactly, and they're all together.
Dances, etc. So you're
the one
around.
Thing I'd like to add. For selfies. Yeah. It is selfie wonderland.
See, also, don't forget that when Prince Harry.
See the stress layer on the bride and the groom. Yeah. When they're going through
this happy
ceremony,
stress.
So it's, no,
it's a happy
I'm
stress.
Sorry, it's not.
You know, like when Prince Harry got married, the entire country celebrated. There were 5 lakh tourists. There were no hotel rooms available in London. There was memorabilia being sold. The entire country benefited, you know, it helped the economy. So we must never forget the wedding industry employs thousands and lakhs of people. It's a fast growing industry. And you cannot understand the value
of that. Can't ignore, yes, it's billions of dollars worth and it's growing. Yes, any opinion, question?
Hello everyone, this is Chetan. And actually, I don't have a question, I have an opinion.
Sure.
Like all of us here are saying that these kind of marriages are putting up pressure on society. Well, I think it's the mentality of our society that creates that pressure. Like if I were a billionaire, I would like my marriage to be the best. But I'm not a billionaire. Like I am a middle class guy. So their financial status allows them to, you know, allows them to spend all those money. But do I have those finances? No.
So you just look at it like a like an event that's happening. Mukesh Ambani's daughter is getting married. It's a massive, you know, you have Hillary Clinton there. You
I
have
think,
Beyonce
I think
there.
We should not compare.
But it doesn't pressurize you in any way because you know.
No, not at all. Because I think that's we should not compare ourselves with them. Look at their financial status also. Look at their status also. And I'm not that rich. So why would I compare like I also want that langa, not langa. I also want.
Right, I get your point.
Okay,
you
can
feel,
I say
you
something?
Feel pressurized, yes.
But you see, if the media, which brings this information to all of us, how else do we see it? We see it on way of media. So if they made heroes of people like him, then there's an equal opportunity. One has choices. Maybe the society will pick up the second trend. Or we have alternative industry, which is the budget industry of weddings, which can also be created like a parallel industry. So there's the high
and
end.
And in this time of when
but
we
I
talk about,
not
yeah. worry about environment and
would
you
not
know,
address
climate,
the question of
carbon
interest
footprint.
In it, as well as Leher's point of, you know, is there joy in it? You know, when you're actually conserving that, it's almost like being on a fast.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's get some more questions.
Hi, my name is Manish. I'm from partyshati.com. यहाँ पे किसी ने कहा था कि दीपिका जो लहंगा पहनेगी मैं भी वैसे ही पहनना चाहती हूँ. देखिए, रणवीर सिंह, रणबीर कपूर दिन में 5 बार कपड़े चेंज करते हैं. दैट डजंट मीन कि हम भी 5 बार चेंज करें. हमें उनको कॉपी
नहीं, बट डोंट यू फील दैट एवरीबॉडी डज लुक एट द क्लोथ्स एट दीस वेडिंग्स एंड लेट्स फेस इट इन चांदनी चौक यू हैव डिजाइनर्स नॉकिंग देम आउट कॉपीज एंड ऑल्सो इट्स एस्पिरेशनल. You know, girls want things like that for their wedding.
But अगर दीपिका 25 लाख या 30 लाख का जो लहंगा ले रही है, that doesn't mean कि वो भी 25 लाख का लेंगी. वो
नहीं, but वो
शायद कॉपी वर्जन ले, 12,000 का मिले, 15,000 का मिले.
Okay, all right, that's a different point there. Yes,
that's it.
अशोक कुमार दिलसाद गार्डन से हम जो लोग डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, मेरे हिसाब से ऐसा नहीं होता. एक आदमी अपने लेवल का सोचता. हमारे समाज में ए लेवल भी सारे तरह के लोग होते हैं. अब एक झुग्गी में रहने वाला थोड़ी ऊपर ही सोचेगा, या मिडल मैन, बिलो मैन. उस जो दीपिका की कैटेगरी है वो ही सोच सकता है कि इतना मुझे खर्चा करना पड़ेगा. अदरवाइज तो एक मीडियम आदमी 1 लाख की भी शादी करता है, 5 लाख की करता है, 20 लाख की करता है. 1 लाख वाले 1 लाख तक के लेवल को ढूंढेगा वहाँ पे. कई लोग ऐसे भी हैं जो डाउरी की वजह से 2 लाख 1 लाख भी नसीब नहीं कर पाता. तो मेरी सरकार से रिक्वेस्ट है कि इन लोगों की मदद करे, जो बेचारे छोटे लोग हैं 2-4-5 लाख, जो कि उसके लिए बहुत जरूरी है.
सरकार कैसे मदद करेगी लोगों की?
नहीं, जब सरकार टैक्स ले सकती है तो जो इस पोजीशन में नहीं है कि जो उसको मिनिमम खर्चा करना चाहिए वो समाज करे, सरकार करे, कोई ना कोई उसको आगे आना चाहिए. या उसको डाउरी
स्कूल और हॉस्पिटल दे दे.
ऑलराइट, सो सपोर्ट
पैसे वाले अरबपति का कोई दिक्कत नहीं आती. अरबपति बहुत है, उसके लिए और भी हो जाते हैं, लेकिन जो मेन गरीब आदमी है
नहीं, लेकिन आपको लगता नहीं जो आप अपने लेवल से
हमारे समाज में ऐसे लोग हैं
शादी करवानी चाहिए,
समाज करते हैं, समाज वाले ही करते हैं उसकी हेल्प, लेकिन सरकार को भी आना, जब सरकार टैक्स ले सकती है तो क्या उन लोगों की मदद नहीं करनी चाहिए जो शादी बेचारे नहीं कर सकते हैं। इस हिसाब से नेताओं को भी आगे आना चाहिए, नेता अपना प्रचार तो करें, ये समाज में लिस्ट बनाए कौन कौन गरीब लोग हैं जिसकी मदद करनी चाहिए।
सरकार मदद करती है, जो विडो किसी महिला की बेटी की शादी है तो सरकार उसमें हेल्प करती है, लेकिन अगर कोई गरीब आदमी ये कहे कि मुझे रणवीर कपूर जैसी या रणवीर सिंह जैसी शादी करनी है तो उस पर सरकार
और दिस इज अ होल डिफरेंट इशू वी गोइंग इनटू ओवर हियर। ओके, लेट्स गेट इन सम मोर ओपिनियंस हियर।
आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई हैव क्वेश्चन टू ऑल पैनलिस्ट। As all I know that big fat weddings are the wastage of money, but instead of that, when we talking about the big fat weddings, we concerning the 1% of the people. When we talk about rest of the 99% of the people,
they're not even 1%. I think they're much
0.1%.
Okay. The rich, the very, very rich.
A statistic said that the 80% of the loans were taken to meet the demand of dowry. Even after that, one woman dies in India in every hour in dowry related case.
All right, so he's making the point again that social ills. Archana, what do you feel about that? So this dowry issue, this overexpenditure on weddings, you feel it's all interconnected at some level?
Social media, movies, they do influence all classes, whether it be the rich, the poor, everybody is influenced, the dress sense, etc., etc. So I still feel these big fat weddings are a huge, I'd say a waste. It's their money, all right, I agree. But it's my
opinion. As Leher was making the point about, it's a joyous occasion and the families do want to.
You know, my niece got married.
Have some pomp and
show and
joy. And
she wanted about 10 functions and she said, I want this. And she was a kid who was looking the most tired, carrying around that Sabyasachi lehenga of maybe 10 kilos. By the end of it, the couple themselves are so fed up.
All right, well, this is something I suppose brides and grooms have to figure out before
we
the
have
wedding.
We have to concede that there is an industry which has grown up, which is a vibrant industry, from wedding cards to wedding planning to locations to food, etc. There is a huge industry. But I think that this industry has grown because of this, rapid aspiration that it's feeding. It's not because of the big fat weddings, let's be very clear. It's the aspirational class which spends not those.
You think overall consumerism is growing in
absolutely.
Our society? And
that
this
is the
just
reason.
Another
it,
part
is a,
of it.
It is a reflection of our consumerism. That's all.
People are spending so much on 40th and 50th birthday parties. They go out of town
exactly
for 4 days,
saying,
5 days. So basically,
so
what's happened?
We're just becoming a very consumerist
all over the
society.
World. No, it's not consumerist. All over the world, when people have a lot of money, they've moved towards experiences. So when somebody's spending this kind of money, it's a splashy show of an experience for his guests. So all the guests who are there at Mukesh Ambani's wedding, it's going to be like a wow. So that's the idea behind throwing these
special weddings. Interesting point. Well, time for us to slip into a short break. We'll be back and we'll talk more about the big fat weddings and what it means for Indian society. Welcome back. We're talking about the big fat Indian wedding and what it means for society. Well, earlier we spoke to actor and comedian Veer Das, and so let's go across to him for more on that, on this issue. Now, Veer, people are questioning why Bollywood stars are going and performing at these weddings. What is your opinion on that? Have you performed at weddings?
I'm just upset that I'm not performing. That would have been a good paycheck. It's absolutely fine. I've done a wedding before. I've done many weddings before. And I think it's absolutely fine for an artist to... if an artist cannot appreciate art at their own wedding, who is going to? I'd much rather do Priyanka Chopra or Deepika Padukone's wedding where it's full of artists who would appreciate my art form than a builder's wedding or dentist's wedding.
All right, well, it's also true, as we've been talking today, that, these weddings generate a lot of business. There's so much involved in the background of a wedding with clothes, cars, makeup, food, invitation, etc. What do you think about that?
आई थिंक सो. आई मीन मेरा तो बड़ा सस्ता था. माई वेडिंग कॉस्ट अ टोटल ऑफ 27 रुपीज. I'm joking. My wife is going to leave me after this. Absolutely. A wedding is huge employment. Isn't the wedding industry over 5,000 crores or something like that in India? It's because we have some of the largest weddings in the world. Like I said, the only thing that should be coming out of your mouth when somebody else is getting married is good wishes and fingers crossed. That's it.
All right, well, that's a nice sentiment that, you know, who are we to judge what people want to do in weddings? But yes, so the big fat wedding here to stay, Dilip. What do you feel?
I think it's here to stay. You'll find it actually moving up the stratospheric level. You'll find less people spending much more and more people hoping to spend much more. But I think less people will spend much, much more. That's going to be...
And hopefully the rest will remain within their means.
The rest won't remain within their means. The rest will aspire to be far out of their means because they want this, you know, hoopla, and they want to attempt to recreate what somebody else who's out of their league has tried to do.
All right, Archana, so you think the media are responsible for creating this hype and hoopla around weddings? Well, there's social media, there are magazines, there's everything around this wedding industry.
I feel the disparity is going to grow. The pressure on the middle classes and the lower classes is going to escalate, and it's going to be a very unhealthy trend. This is my opinion. I know it's their money, they are spending it. But I still feel for the classes that don't have that kind of money.
It creates that pressure, Reena.
Well, I mean, I'd sound obviously like a hypocrite when I give this quote out, but it's just coming up and again in my head. So Mahatma Gandhi said that the rich must live simply so the poor may simply live. So maybe some examples, some heroes need to be created. Media needs to pitch in because media is the biggest way to get the news in your...
But if the rich live simply, then maybe the poor won't be able to earn as much from them.
Possible also because it's an employment generating industry, marriage, the big fat Indian wedding.
Well, from there, I'll go to Chetan, who is a part of that industry. And
I think, I hope it grows, and I hope it continues to grow for people like me and the many other of my industry supporters. However, there is a conscious eye on wastage. A lot of us are doing it. You as a channel, we know, are very passionate about the green agenda and about carbon footprint. A lot of us agencies have started educating clients and saying that. So there is, if somebody does come back and say that we want to build a stage on a lake, we will get back and say, look, there is going to be an environmental damage. Let's not do stuff like that. So there is an eye on wastage. There is an eye on unnecessary splurges. There is a certain consciousness that's being born. And there are some of us who are trying to advocate that. But to answer your question, yes, I hope it does keep growing.
So you're actually looking at, helping couples have a wedding with a low carbon footprint.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And is that even possible in Indian weddings?
Well, so if an Indian family wanting to go abroad, going into a beach, let's say in Ibiza or somewhere else, you don't necessarily need to go and litter the place with garbage later, or you don't need to go and build big stages. And that's why destination wedding and the whole tourism angle is coming into that. So that's a big...
All right, Leher.
Well, Hollywood celebrities have always blurred the lines between the personal and the professional when it comes to weddings. And I read this quote regarding Priyanka Chopra's wedding today. It said, it is a truth universally acknowledged that a famous female celebrity in possession of a fortune will be on the lookout for a husband. It's the Jane Austen quote from Pride and Prejudice.
Okay.
So, meaning this is going to continue. You know, people are going to continue getting married in a lavish way. People will emulate them.
We'll keep having these celebrity weddings,
you're saying. You know, it's just entertainment, and people do see it like that. You know, if we wouldn't have entertainment news if Mukesh Ambani's daughter wasn't getting married or Priyanka Chopra wasn't having this massive celebration, there'd be nothing to talk about, you know.
All right, well, the paradox that is India. 2 weeks ago, we were talking about the Farmers' March in Delhi, and this weekend, it's all about, Mukesh Ambani's wedding, his daughter's wedding, and, all the what's going on there with Beyonce arriving. She's performing tonight. But final word to you, Raviji. आपको क्या कहना है इस पूरे जो हम आज डिस्कस कर रहे थे इस पूरे इशू के बारे में?
देखिए, ये बात तो बिल्कुल सही है कि कोई अपने पैसे को कैसे खर्च कर रहा है हम लोग जज नहीं करना चाहिए, लेकिन ऐसे बहुत सारे उदाहरण हैं हमारे सामने जहां हमने देखा कि एक व्यक्ति ने बहुत ही महंगी शादी करी और कुछ दिनों बाद उसका फाइनेंशियल स्टेटस बहुत ही बुरा था. जब बाद में पता लगा तो उनको ये था कि उन्होंने बहुत सारा कर्जा लिया, क्योंकि वो जो उनका सर्कल था उस सर्कल को मैच करने के लिए उन्होंने सब किया, लेकिन शादी हो गई लेकिन उसके बाद वो बर्बाद हो गए. तो
प्रेशर जो है वो कुछ भी
दिखाने के लिए,
बिल्कुल कुछ भी आप कुछ भी कह लीजिए। जैसे अभी कुछ दिन पहले का उदाहरण है, छोटे भाई हैं, उनका बर्थडे था, तो उन्होंने हमसे कुछ 25-30 हज़ार रुपये मांगे कि पार्टी देनी है। हमने कहा इतनी महंगी पार्टी क्यों? तो उन्होंने कहा कि हमारे सर्कल में एक फ्रेंड है, उसने एक जगह पार्टी दी थी, मुझे भी पार्टी वहीं देनी है। तो ये जहाँ भी आप उठते बैठते हैं,
you were saying, it's not just weddings, it's everything. It's parties, everybody wants to be bigger. आपको लगता है पूरा सोसाइटी हमारा बहुत कंज्यूमरिस्ट हो गया है,
क्योंकि अगर आप उसको मैच नहीं करेंगे तो फिर आपको लगेगा कि वहाँ फिर हम फिट नहीं है।
They want to have fun. It's not consumerist. They all want to have a good time.
And now everybody has the means to and have places where they can have fun.
जी, तो हमें मुझे लगता है कि हमें इसको बढ़ावा ना देकर हमें एक सिंपल एक अच्छी वेडिंग को बढ़ावा देना चाहिए, जहाँ पर जो दोनों फैमिली हैं वो एक्चुअली खुश हो, शादी से पहले भी और शादी के बाद।
All right, well, I think that's a very important note to end on, and let's not just make it all about the wedding. It has to be about the marriage as well. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Thank you. Good night.